What's up, guys? So today I'm taking a little bit of a different approach to my video. I am going to talk about something that I got from another video. So I was watching Roberto Blake, and I'm gonna put his video in the description below. He was talking about an idea that he got because of Casey Neistat, who just published it. And I'll put his video in the description below as well. And that's the pressures of being on YouTube. And I think that it comes in many forms. The way I kind of like to think about it, and it took me a couple of days to really analyze this and think about how I wanted to present this. And I think the pressures equal for everyone, but I think it's kind of a tiered pressure. So there's different tiers of what you're focused on and how that pressure gets to you. So for me, I'm simply starting YouTube. I'm getting my ideas out. I'm finding my niche. I'm putting out content and figuring out how to edit better and mix my song to my video and just really put everything together and figure it out with a schedule of a family and animals and work and trying to still have a social life and having family time and things like that. Like there's a lot of pressures involved in it because I'm always thinking about this and thinking about my next video and how to make myself better. Like there's nights where most nights I don't really sleep too well in the first place, but there's nights where I just kind of think about this and it kind of consumes you really quick if you let it, or it has the ability to consume you really quick if you let it. Whereas I think people like Roberto or Casey, Roberto, I would say he's a fairly well-known YouTuber. He has that following, he has the content, he has his niches figured out, and he's really good at what he does. But I think his pressures come in from more of what gets given to him as feedback, and he puts it as the haters and just the way people treat you, because you're wide open in this market. Like there's no hiding. You are who you are in front of the camera, and you can't hide that. And people will like it and people won't like it. And the people that don't like it will let you know that they don't like it. So you kind of have to find a way to make yourself thick-skinned once you get to that point. And then like Casey, like he's getting up there to where he's almost considered like YouTube royalty, right? He's a really big name, really well known, has a lot of followers, has multiple channels. But I think his pressure is to remain in the spotlight and deal with the pressure that comes with already finding the fame in YouTube. Because once you get to the top, the hardest thing is to maintain that position, right? And stay at the top. But so that's kind of like my tier aspect and what I think of it. I think I think they all have their ultimate stressors. No one's more stressed than the other unless they allow themselves to get there. But what I want to focus on is the little guy because that's where I'm at and that's what I know. And the stress is to make it, right? And you, like I was saying earlier, you kind of get overwhelmed or you get so enveloped in this process and the possibility to make it, but you don't think about what you're really sacrificing. And like, yeah, you might get the popularity, you might make it on YouTube, you might start getting sponsored and start bringing in money, but you think about it, you hit that monetization point for YouTube and you figure out how to work the algorithm into your favor, or you start collabing with the right people so your channel just blows up and you get lucky and you hit that one video that just goes viral and you figure out how to ride it out and build your brand. And the pressure is there to constantly do it, to find the way to get better, to do better, to be more. And it's hard sometimes. It's taxing. It's really rough. And we can't let ourselves forget that there are other aspects of life. Like, yes, this can be a great career. This can be a way to have a lot of fun. This is what you make it. YouTube is what you put into it. Plain and simple. But YouTube can be your greatest ally or your worst enemy, depending on what you allow it to be. So my point is find a happy medium. Don't let this consume you. Let this be a way to invest in yourself and market yourself, but don't make it your sole purpose. Otherwise, it will consume you and it will drive you insane. I hope you guys have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon. What's up, guys? My name is John. Welcome to. Ooh. The tier that I'm going to focus on is a new YouTuber because that's what I am and what I deal with. And no, that's not what I am? Okay. But yeah, I'm lost.